Hunger among Filipino families fell in September. According to a social weather station survey, the hunger rate fell to 10% from 13.6% in June. That translates to a drop from 3.4 million families going hungry in June to just 2.5 million in September. The survey was conducted among 1,200 adults last September 12 to 16. The survey also noted hunger declined in all areas except in Metro Manila, which recorded a 14% hunger incidence. The country's unemployment rate fell to 7.4% in October from 8.9% in September. That's equivalent to 3.5 million jobless Filipinos for the month. A big portion of the job losses were in the education as well as the financial and insurance sectors. The agriculture and retail industries, meanwhile, contributed the most jobs as the lowering of the alert level in the National Capital Region allowed more establishments to reopen. The Philippines' economic managers expect better numbers in the November labor survey due to the further easing of COVID restrictions. They say sustaining these gains will allow the local economy to rebound to pre-pandemic levels in early 2022. Philippine inflation eases for the third straight month thanks to lower food prices. Inflation hit 4.2% in November, a four-month low. According to the Philippine Statistics Authority, the heavily weighted food and non-alcoholic beverages index slid to 3.9% during the month from 5.3% in October. That's mainly due to a drop in vegetable prices and lower increments in meat and fish prices. November's figure brings average inflation to 4.5%, which is still above government's full-year target range of 2-4%. The latest inflation print also went above the Philippine Central Bank's forecast range of 3.3-4.1% for November. But the BSP still sees average inflation falling within the government's target next year and in 2023 as supply-side pressures moderate. At least one economist agrees with the central bank's assessment.
The main drivers of inflation are food and fuel prices. And we've seen, I believe that we've seen the peak in crude oil prices. They're about 20% lower than their peak. With regard to food prices, my own studies has been had shown that it's really transitory. I do expect that even food prices will, you know, ease a bit. And my projection for next year really is around 3.5% inflation rate. By the first quarter of the year, you will see a inflation headline inflation rate actually averaging below 3%.
The BSP adds demand-side inflationary pressures may be dampened by potential delays in the lifting of domestic lockdown measures and the emergence of the Omicron COVID variant.